Boomba, boomba, boomba. Really loves the biryani, chicken legs and all that. Put them in the center. Sprinkle the rice like this. The raw tomatoes are on the top. I'm going to take these punctured tomatoes, make them salan. One of the best biryani rice. Look at this beautiful carving. Namaste, Salam Alaikum, Sasri Akal. Welcome back to Golden Harvest Presents Vareva Cooking. Today we're going to cook for a cooking competition and we're going to use Golden Harvest Basmati rice. And we have the Lajawab, which is my favorite for making any of the mutton, chicken and other biryanis. And we have the Pulao Basmati and we have Golden Harvest Laziz and we have Golden Harvest Hyderabadi Basmati rice and we also have Dilkush. So you have different range of basmati rice at Golden Harvest. Today I'm going to show a chicken biryani which actually some of the participants for the cooking competition with Golden Harvest Basmati rice that was held in Hyderabad. The competition, I told them, you have to make chicken biryani using tomato. So the creativity, the buzz that came out, we're going to see on this show today. For today's cooking competition, we're going to use Golden Harvest Lajawab Basmati rice, which is extra long grain basmati rice. Whenever you're making biryani, make sure you soak the rice at least for 20 minutes so that your rice will come out perfect. And we're going to marinate the chicken. So for 1 kg of basmati rice, you usually use 2 kg, but I'm going to use 1.5 kg of chicken. So this chicken has been brined. That means I bought the chicken, I put it in the salt water so the chicken is nice and tender. You know, whatever size of pieces, you know, we got some chicken legs and all that. For making this, we're going to marinate the chicken. I'm going to use chili powder, coriander powder, some cumin seed powder, garam masala powder. See, this is very flavorful basmati rice. The entire thing will come out absolutely tasty. And in this, add salt. And also, when you marinate the chicken, you need to add oil. We're going to add some oil in this. Mint leaves, green chili, yogurt. Marinate the chicken. Look at this. Nice, the chicken pieces, the leg pieces, big ones. I'll put them in the center. Then you're going to spread this evenly so that they are not two pieces. Each piece is touching at the bottom. Now we're going to cook the Golden Harvest Lajawab Basmati rice and we're going to put it on the layer. The creativity is in the stuffing of a tomato. So here is the sesame seed, peanut, coconut powder. In this, add chili powder, add some coriander powder, some salt, add some chopped coriander. We're going to squeeze in some lemon juice. So this mixture is nice. This is what one of the participants did. What they did, they took a tomato, they made a hollow and they stuffed this coriander in here. The stuffing is done. And I'm going to show you how we're going to stuff it in the chicken biryani. When the water comes to a boil, add salt. And always remember, the salt is the most important part of the biryani. And in this, we're going to use the Sanghi's Kitchen's masalas. So Sanghi's Kitchen has, you know, red chilies and all the masalas. Use the Sanghi's Kitchen masalas and then here I'm going to add some cloves, some cardamom, just to flavor the biryani rice, and mace, some shahi jeera, one biryani leaf, black cardamom, star anise and cinnamon. When you add this, the water color also gets slightly yellowish. In this, we're going to add, you know, lemon with skin just to give a little bit of nice color and the flavor. So this we're going to remove it off later. And now we're going to add the rice. Golden Harvest Lajawab Basmati rice. Just before adding the rice, add oil. Otherwise, you know, see, you want the rice to be nice, fluffy. For 1 kg rice, add 1 or 2 tablespoons of oil. So in this, we're going to add the rice. We are going to use the draining method. That means when the rice is ready, we're going to pour this rice on top of the chicken. Then only you will get that rice nice and fluffy. So mix it one time after you add the rice and slowly bring this to a boil and then let it cook till the rice is perfectly done. Look at this rice, they are expanding, they're becoming long and perfect. So almost 75% done. So I'm going to keep this here and I'm going to bring the chicken which has been marinated and I'm going to transfer this rice on top of that. Chicken is perfect. I'm going to add some brown onion. And this brown onion I'm putting on top, you can mix it in the chicken also, but on the top it gives better flavor. Now, the rice is sitting there. If you leave it there, it will be fully cooked. So, we're going to take the rice like this. You're going to sprinkle the rice like this. So layer by layer, the first layer is corn at the bottom, and then the second layer. Like this, we're going to finish all this rice. This is the technique, what we do at the restaurants, that we just don't dump the rice, we don't drain it, and then try to dump everything here. So very carefully, we're going to love each grain of the rice, then only you will get this perfect. You know, the moisture that is there in the chicken should be enough to cook this rice. But always keep the drained water, hot water, at least some ready in case. On top of this, once again, we're going to have some of the mint leaf, the brown onion, the tomatoes. What to do is just put the tomatoes with the lid on. Lid on means with their head on, and these will cook perfectly. So now the raw chicken is inside and the raw tomatoes are on the top, and we're going to put a dum and we're going to seal this. The last thing to do is put some saffron water. Take a dough, you know, slightly wet your hands so that this sticks to the thing, and then we're going to seal the pot. So now we're going to put a lid on like this, and you can add some weight on top so everything will get cooked perfectly. You know, after around 20-25 minutes of cooking, the steam is coming on the side, so I'm going to shed this off and I'm going to make another salan. This salan also with tomato, because the tomato is a concept, we're going to make it super delicious salan using tomato. For making the salan, we're going to add some oil in a pan. In the oil, we're going to add the mustard seeds. When they crackle, we're going to add red chili, cumin seed, the methi dana, and kalonji, the onion seeds. And in this, we're going to add the onion. We're going to fry the onions till they are nice and golden, and also the flavoring for a good salan, the curry leaves, we're going to add. And also add some salt and fry the onions till they are slightly golden. We're going to add some ginger garlic paste, turmeric, coriander powder, cumin powder, chili powder. We're going to add the paste. This is the paste of sesame seed, coconut and peanut. This is what we usually make for the all the salans. Mix all of this, and this mixture will get stuck at the bottom very easily. Cook this masala fine. Now you can look, the masala is all cooked and it's got the nice color. In this, we're going to add tamarind juice. And tamarind juice, just right enough to give little sourness, not too much. And also add water, and you cook this to the desired consistency. In this, we're going to add some chopped green chili, because in the salan, the green chilies give a very good flavor, but I'm not adding big, because this is a tomato salan, I'm chopped the green chili and added. So for the chicken salan, so what we're going to do, we're going to take a tomato, we're going to take a, you know, stick, and then we're going to make holes. Puncture this tomato like this. Now this is all ready. So now the gravy is also perfect, but I'm going to add a little bit of jaggery. This salan gravy, pinch of jaggery will be excellent taste. And the consistency of this gravy is also coming out nice and perfect. I'm going to take these punctured tomatoes and make them sit in this gravy. We're going to let this cook for few minutes, and we're going to do that cooking competition presentation of this chicken biryani. Look at this beautiful cooking competition kind of presentation, and I'm going to explain about what these beautiful things are all about. And when you are taking part in a cooking competition, you better do the presentation. Let's say you have 40 marks, 10 marks will go for presentation, and that is one place where you can take 10 out of 10, and that will help you win a cooking competition. So here, the chicken biryani, look at it. The whole idea, this is a tomato has to be used in this competition. So the tomatoes are sitting still and they are full of juice. And look at this rice. First, we're going to take some of this tomato on the side. The chicken, the biryani is perfectly cooked, and the pieces of chicken inside. Now you got to showcase your tomato, because the tomato is the king. And a nice chicken tender piece on the side will also do good. Just before serving, serve some Nilgiri ghee on the sides, and this will start melting and it will give a very nice aroma and the flavor out. You know, whenever you take part in a cooking competition, you might have cooked the best food, but presentation, as I told you, is important. So when you put a biryani, maybe, you know, put a small spring of mint. When a lot of times I see mistake, see, these are brown onions. Even high fry, sometimes some of the onions can get black. So be careful and select the best of the best onion to go onto your presentation. So I've seen that too many times that they put brown onions but they are burnt. So you have to be very careful that you do good. Not just the biryani alone. They have to be impressed with your entire skill set. So where do you show your skills? Now look at this beautiful carving. We have made the flowers with the radish and the cucumber, and we made this using the spring onion. We made an excellent one. Lot of times you can bring the garnish ready-made from home, so you can make some effort and bring it. If they say no, then you can remove it off. What is the theme today? Using tomato in the chicken biryani. We not only stuffed the tomatoes with excellent masalas in this, but also look at this beautiful candle here. See, this candle is made with a tomato. So the tomato is slit and there is a candle inside. This is adding so much beauty to it. And now look at the raita. You know, a lot of times I've seen people giving raita in just cups. When you're going to a competition, you want to show your skills. So what I did, I kind of took thick yogurt and made a raita, and you know, so that it can set. I've set that like that and then put some tomato. The tomato salan is there. The biryani has to be made with tomato, beautiful tomato salan, and all these things will make it absolutely perfect. So today I can call this Lajawab biryani because this is Golden Harvest Lajawab basmati rice we have used, and we are at a Golden Harvest cooking competition. The first thing I'll do is come taste a little bit of rice, perfectly cooked. Second thing is I want to taste the chicken. Is the chicken flavorful enough? The chicken, the bone is separating out of the chicken, and chicken is also slightly colored. That means perfectly cooked. There is so much of masalas. So now he has to taste it, and now he's already wowed. The judge must have never seen a tomato stuffed like this. They will be super impressed and you will be given full marks. And look at this raita. Now the attention will go. What is this? You have to communicate your creativity to the judge. You have to tell them how you have made this. I'm just going to put the spoon. Look at that, how soft the yogurt is. And the judge will be like, shit, this guy seemed to be better than me. I have to give him full marks. When this is so good, they're going to taste it. Just too good. Now, it doesn't matter if your salan is tasty or not. You already won the judge's heart. And anyway, for the heaven's sake, they will just dip into the salan. The judge will go crazy. He will start doing boomba, boomba, boomba. So whether the judge does the boomba or not, your one is hot. Now you know how to take part into a competition. You know the great presentation. The accompaniment's perfect. The biryani perfect. The props are good. And actually, you opened your mouth and explained your concept to the judge. Judge will be impressed. And I go as a judge in a lot of cooking competitions. And if you are able to do this much, I'll guarantee you, you will get the first prize. This Lajawab rice is so beautiful. The Golden Harvest has one of the best rice. My son really loves the biryani when I make it with Golden Harvest Lajawab. Golden Harvest means bringing alive the magic of Golden Harvest Barpet Pyar in your homes.